actually recreating an extinct species is not in the realm of possible right now. There is a lot more to be learned. Through the science of paleogenetics, the scientists found the genome of direwolves went extinct 12,000 years ago, and they extracted and sequenced the DNA from tissue samples that they found, and there was a tremendous amount of computational effort that went into assembling the genome of these direwolves. They used genetic engineering, specifically CRISPR editing, to modify 15 genes of gray wolves to introduce the genetic code from direwolves to get the characteristics that they wanted to see. So specifically, the team predicted that a certain set of genes would lead to a certain set of characteristics that they wanted to see. Actually, recreating a species is not in the realm of possible now, not remotely in the realm of possible now. We have too little knowledge of how the genetic code makes living organisms and the complex biology that makes species distinct from each other. The genetic code of humans and chimpanzees is 98.8% identical. But we know that we have evolved very far from each other. And so there is just a lot more to be learned. We can learn many new lessons from the biology of yesterday. How species lived in their environments, how they were successful in their environments, how they migrated, how they evolved. And that tells us a lot about the present world. Extracting the DNA and assembling the genome from these extremely degraded, very hard to find, very small samples of tissues is an extremely large technological challenge. The genome is a collection of genes that code for proteins that do the work of making life work. It also contains non-coding parts that are mostly important for regulating all of the machinery that makes life work. The CRISPR system has a protein that can cut DNA, and it has an RNA piece that guides the protein to a specific location on the DNA so that the protein can make a cut at that location. And then the cell repairs the cut DNA. And if you engineer a specific code into that RNA piece that guided the DNA, the protein to that location, then the cell can incorporate that information, that code, into the repaired DNA. And that is what allows you to make specific changes in the genetic code at specific locations in the genome. So that allows you to precisely edit the genome where you need to make the change.